Hello guys, Wilfred here, and today I'll be talking about some of the features that make the Google Pixel 6 a quite smart smartphone. All the beautiful features this phone launches with, the one that stands out to me the most isn't even the camera, but the Google Tensor chip and the implications of that capable machine learning chipset. And so, one of the features we'll be looking at today is the recording feature. You know, Google implements a high level of speech-to-text processing, and that's one of the beauties of this device. So, the app that stands out to me the most is the recorder app. So let's quickly jump in and go to the recorders app, and we have Google telling us to record respectfully around others. Jumping in, if we click this recorder app here, I see that the mic on this phone is top-notch, really. It's a great mic set. They capture words quite plain and clear and sounds quite easily. But that's not just the thing I just want to talk about, really, is the high level of speech to text integration this phone achieves that really baffles me. And if we come here and tap on transcript, we see a live transcription of whatsoever I am saying in a quite accurate format. It's able to capture speech nuances, punctuation, and make a quite accurate transcript of whatsoever is being said. This feature is a banger for me on this phone. It's beautiful, and this is made possible by the Google Pixel chipset. A chipset that is so capable on the machine learning radar. So, naturally, I am someone who have some knowledge around machine learning, especially natural language processing, as I have a level of experience in cognitive science. That's not just what baffles me about this device. The device implements a wide range of machine learning models that helps it to do things that are so power demanding in the first place, but are not being done offline, not being translated on a Google server somewhere. No. Everything that I'm saying and the processing that is happening to a high, very possible accuracy level is being done on the chip locally. How great is that? So that's one of the features I like about this device, is the recorder app for me, a great level of speech to text transcription and processing. In the science world, it's called natural language processing. And that, my friend, is a beauty. Stopping this right now, I can click save. Google does a kind of naming of whatsoever audio you've made. Okay, we have the option to come here and click this audio that has been recorded and share either the transcript file on Google Docs or text file, or go into what we call just the audio or video clip. I really love this. It's a format where the Pixel combines the wave form of the audio you've recorded and the transcription that has been made. Remember, the transcriptions that you've done could be edited to make sure everything is very accurate. And so we can come here and go back to that feature I was about to describe. It's called the video to clip. And so we can select layout, either portrait mode, or we're going into landscape mode. So I think I prefer this mode. And so we can go into theme and select the white background. I love this white, it looks beautiful, it looks sexy on the eye, yeah. So I can tap create, and the device creates a video format that has an integration of the waveform and the audio that has been recorded on the device and transcribed. So let's wait a bit on our video that has been created here. Can tap in. I really love that feature, and I see myself using it constantly, and I like that about this device. So one other feature we will discuss on the feature drop is live translation. Although I won't be covering everything on live translation right now, but I just want you to know that if you go to the setting under accessibility settings, accessibility, Okay, we can say live translation, live caption, live transcribe, live translate. This is a beautiful one, yeah. I love the capability this Tensor chip holds. This is not the most powerful chipset out there. It's not the best out there, but when it comes to machine learning functionality, models, implementation, the Google Pixel stands out. It stands out the best. And Google, I remember Google saying most of the things that have been done on this device, the translation, the transcription, and the ML stuff that have been done are done at half the power consumption compared to other processes or other devices. And that's a beauty, really. I love this device. I see myself using these features. If this can be my primary device, no doubt, I would really, really love it. So those are the beautiful features here. And so we've discussed one of the things that make the Google Pixel one of the smartest smartphones in the market right now. It's not just one of the smartest smartphones. This device is the smartest smartphone out there. And it's made possible by the high degree of machine learning and AI capabilities. And so that will be all for now. Please subscribe to the channel because more stuff related to the Pixel and other devices will be dropping as time goes on. Take care of yourself and stay pixelicious. Bye for now.